Hey everybody, my name is Rebecca Johnson and I'm a licensed mental health counselor. I specialize in narcissistic abuse recovery. I have been doing quite a few videos for adult children of narcissists just to help educate you and help guide you along your healing journey. So today I'm changing it up just a little bit and I'm going to give you the top seven books, my favorite books for adult children of narcissists. So the first one, my definite favorite, is Healing from Hidden Abuse by Shannon Thomas. The title officially is Healing from Hidden Abuse, A Journey Through the Stages of Recovery from Psychological Abuse. This is my number one for sure. I recommend this book often to my clients who may be in a romantic relationship that is abusive or have an emotionally abusive parent. So what Shannon does in this book, she does it so well. She gives quite an education on the different traits of survivors, which I also love that she uses the word survivor and not victim. And she also gives really great descriptions on the traits of abusers. She walks you through all six stages that she has determined for recovering from psychological abuse. One really great tool that she offers, it's in the back of the book, is a letter. An outline of a letter that if you are a survivor of psychological abuse, it is something you can share with your loved ones to help really put words to what you've experienced. She also offers journal prompts at the back of the book, which can really lead to even further insight in just your own reflection on your own experience. So the next book I recommend often and that I really, really love is called Adult Children of Emotionally Immature Parents, How to Heal from Distant, Rejecting, and Self-Involved Parents by Lindsey Gibson. So what I love about this book the most, it is super practical, gives you a lot of good tips and advice. It also offers stories and scenarios that may feel really relatable to you. It will help you avoid getting hooked by your emotionally immature parent. It will help you determine the different types of emotionally immature parent. It has a lot of very practical exercises throughout the book too, which I believe can be really healing, right? Just to go through those checklists and answer different questions for yourself. My next book that I definitely recommend specific to adult daughters of narcissistic mothers is Mothers Who Can't Love, A Healing Guide for Daughters by Susan Forward. This is another great resource, particularly if you are a woman raised by a narcissistic mother. It will help you identify the different types of toxic mothers, different wounds that are inflicted on daughters. Susan also includes different scenarios and stories that you're gonna really find relatable and helpful and feel you're gonna feel really validated by that. She helps you move through identifying the lies, the truth, how much pain you're experiencing, also to really help you identify the anger and even the grief that you're dealing with when you have a narcissistic mother. She also gives really great tips and advice on how to change your own behavior and how to set boundaries. And in the last part of the book, she offers ideas and suggestions on how to move forward. The next book is, again, another one for adult daughters of narcissistic mothers. It's called Will I Ever Be Good Enough? Healing the Daughters of Narcissistic Mothers. I gotta share with you that this is one of the very first books I read way back in the day, and it was life-changing for me. It was really, really helpful and really healing for me. So through this book, Karyl will help you recognize and identify what the actual issues are in your relationship with your mother. She also offers different questionnaires, which are really helpful to go through these different traits and characteristics to help you give you words for what you're experiencing. This is another book that shares different stories and scenarios. Again, very relatable, very validating to know that you are not the only one that has experienced these things. She talks about how your mother has affected your life and maybe the different traits that you've picked up because of that experience. And then towards the back of the book, she offers different recovery steps to heal that include really learning more about yourself, establishing boundaries, and self-care. So the next three books I'm going to talk about kind of get off the track a little bit of narcissistic parents and are a little more general. Next book is called When Pleasing You is Killing Me, Setting Boundaries with the Controllers in Your Life. This one's by Les Carter. Les also has another book that is called enough about you, let's talk about me. That is specific to narcissists. So that one's also a good one, not on this list, but another great resource. So Les really talks about different people-pleasing patterns. He shares with you how being a people-pleaser can make you vulnerable to controlling people in your life. This is another one that offers really great journal prompts and steps and tips and exercises to really help guide you through the whole process. He talks about reacting to anger and grief and pride throughout this whole process. He talks about how you can find balance when you have controllers in your life. Again, not specific to parents, but really the whole world of controlling people. This is a really good resource. Les also offers traits of healthy relationships, so really good takeaways on how you can just move forward and form and establish healthy relationships in your life. Next one is Boundaries by Henry Cloud and John Townsend. One of my favorites, and this, even if you don't have a toxic parent, this is such good life advice all around in all of your relationships. Just so you know, it is biblically based, so it comes from a really sound faith-based perspective. He has updated it several times. There are also different editions for boundaries in marriage, boundaries with your kids. What's the other one? Oh, boundaries for leaders. So anything by Dr. Cloud or Dr. Townsend is going to be just really life-changing. In this book, they talk about how to develop boundaries, what boundaries are, different examples of boundaries, what they look like, what they feel like. One of my favorites, recommended all the time. And last but not least, Setting Boundaries, Find Peace, A Guide to Reclaiming Yourself. And forgive me if I mispronounce this, Nedra Glover Twob. So forgive me, Nedra, if I have mispronounced your name. This is the most recent addition to my therapeutic library. It's fairly new. Another very sound and practical book on advice for boundaries. It will help you understand what boundaries are, the importance of setting boundaries. It also includes a really great section on the cost of not having boundaries in your life. She talks about the six different boundaries, physical boundaries, intellectual boundaries, et cetera, et cetera. She will show you how to communicate these boundaries. She will actually give examples too of setting boundaries within your family, within your workplace, even in social media and technology. In this book, she also offers a self-assessment. So I love those types of things, self-assessment questionnaires, journal prompts, outlines, those types of exercises that can really be helpful and really help you dig in to your own healing. She also includes commonly asked questions, and she's really great about answering and just really bullet pointing a lot of good stuff. So I hope you have found this list helpful in your own journey. Again, these are the books that I would recommend specific if you have a narcissistic parent. In future videos, I'm going to do a video specific to if you're married to a narcissist, if you're in a romantic relationship, if you're divorcing a narcissist. Stay tuned for those. I can't wait to share that information with you. I so appreciate everybody chiming in, leaving me comments, for liking my videos. And if you really like this content and if you want to see more of it, please make sure you have subscribed to my channel, and also make sure that little bell is clicked so you get notifications when new content is out. Thank you so much.